It has been a stain on the reputation of the Sydney Opera House for decades. Now technicians believe they have finally fixed the acoustic problems which have plagued the world-famous music venue. An upgraded concert hall is the final piece of a decade-long upgrade that's cost more than $300 million.
The hall is once again alive with the sound of music. Closed for the past 2.5 years, the Opera House Concert Hall has undergone its largest upgrade since opening in 1973. Less of a facelift, this was more of an ear lift, fixing a sound problem that's plagued the World Heritage Site.
Musicians around the world dream of playing here, but all too often the experience has fallen short of expectations.
Impressive architecture has been let down by acoustics that were anything but. Actor John Malkovich described them as hideous, a review that didn't sit well with the premier of the day.
He can have a go at our opera house, but I'll tell you what, he's a very, very average actor.
But Malkovich wasn't wrong. The concertmaster of the Sydney Symphony Orchestra says there were acoustic black spots.
We were basically shouting for the last 40 years.
That's now a thing of the past. New wooden ripples act to soften the sound, while the stage is 40 centimetres closer to the audience with automated risers for musicians. And gone are those famous clear donuts above, replaced with 18 panels that can be angled to reflect sound to different parts of the 45-metre-long hall.
You can sit in every single seat in this hall and hear absolutely perfectly.
We know the musicians like the way it sounds. The big question, though, is what will audiences think, especially back up here in the cheap seats? Currently, a team of international experts are using these acoustic meters. You can see one behind me here to gauge how the sound travels. But what no one knows yet is what it will sound like when 2,500 people are in here, because that could change everything.
The proof will be in the pudding, but I am extremely excited to find out.
It opens to the public on Wednesday. Time to face the music. Lachlan Kennedy for 10 News First.